going on, guys? Back at it again, finally. So Saturday, what is it, November 5th? It's actually like 77 degrees today. It's really warm, but finally got out here to the land, get some work done. Rifle season is starting next Saturday, actually, and I'm so far behind on trying to get some stuff that I wanted done before the kids got out here with the rifles. Yes, I said kids, because my daughter has showed some interest in actually harvesting a deer this year, so I'm super stoked about that. I'm not gonna push it too much because I don't want to like force her into doing something, but Henner coming out here if she wants to sit with me and watch. So yeah, I'm super stoked about that. But today I've got a lot of stuff I gotta try to get accomplished out here. Forgive me if you see me walking around like I'm an old man, but my back's been hurting pretty good this morning, and waiting for the ibuprofen to kick in. So with that said, today I got the tractor out here finally, and the reason why it's been a while for me getting out here is this has been super busy, and I'm sorry for the wind, guys. I'll try to speak up a little louder. But it's been a super busy season. My son started baseball back up again this past season, so he was playing baseball, having practice, several practices and games a week. Daughter, I was coaching her rec league, had a practice during the week, and the games were on Saturdays. And then it was very fortunate she was able to try out for the middle school soccer team, and she made that as well. So she's had soccer practices and trying to get to all her games, make sure I'm there for it. So it's been super busy. Me and Brady were sitting here saying this is probably the busiest we've ever been in our lives with school functions, but we always want to be there for them, make sure they know that we're there for the games, and I enjoy watching it. Baseball's kind of hard to watch for me, but I'm still there for Hut Bud. But anyways, today finally get the tractor out here. You can see the food plot back here in the back. It's been growing up. I've had some deer on a lot of deer actually showing up in the area, but I had one good photo of it, and I'll try to add it in here, of a doe. She's got a mouth full of grass right in front of the camera, which means they're eating it and they're showing up, so that's good. So I'm actually right here on my platform, and my goal today, man, that wind is brutal. My goal today is I bought three of these metal structures that would be perfect to set up here, and then I want to wrap it with some camouflage. So you have a seating station here, and you'll be able to look down this way and be covered, and you'd also have this field as well that I've seen them grazing in. So it'd be a super easy place to get in and out of, especially for beginners with my kids. And then also I have friends that are Daniel and his wife, they're wanting to harvest a deer this year real well, Dana, so I'm trying to hook them up. So I'm gonna try to get that platform on here, but I had to use a tractor because it's very heavy, and get that on here wrapped up. I've also got another spot in the back that I've got the platform already set up, but I want to put a pop-up on it. And I also, I've got a stand back here that I've been using for bow season, but I'm wanting to clear out a shooting lane inside the woods, so I'm gonna have to go around, come in and start using my box blade to start clearing out some of that brush so I can see a lot better. Rifle season, it's just been bugging me last season. I couldn't see as much back there through thorns and thickets and stuff like that, but it's gonna be a busy day, but I like it. I like it because there's nothing else on my agenda. The daughter's at a birthday parties this weekend, and Brittany and my son are out having a mother-son day. They're going to watch a movie and eat lunch and all that good stuff. But I'm going to show you all these metal platforms that I bought. I actually got these off of Marketplace. I'm always shopping on Marketplace on Facebook and trying to find deals and stuff. But I got three of these structures. You see me standing, I'm 5'10", so it's sitting about 4 feet tall and probably a good 6 feet long. So I bought three of them, two of them stainless, one regular, and the guy I bought them from is out near Western Alamance. He said they're actually used for storage or transportation of like rolls of cloth. So actually, if you flip these upside down, they actually would stack all the cloth inside of it, and then this would be the bottom, and then they would be able to lift it up and transport it. So they were 60 bucks each on there. I said, heck, I'll go ahead and buy it. Even I had plans to do this, but then also later down, if we have cattle, or I mean livestock, thing about goat huts and all that stuff, be able to put, just wrap it with metal, and then I have a little hut. So goal is get two of these on the platform and wrap it up, and then start working on other stuff. But y'all just stay tuned. Alright guys, here is the finished product. Well, semi-finished. I need to get one more piece of net and put on this side right here. And zip tie some more. So what I have is one of those standing straight up. And then I put another one and I laid it down on its side. Covered the top with some of this, I guess it's like a rubber mat. Almost like a roofing material, but there's some out here, so went ahead and put it on top. So if it's raining, keep the rain off. But yeah, got plenty of room on the inside, be able to walk up, go through this hole, and then have this to sit in. So it's plenty enough room, and then you'll have view on both sides all the way down into the shooting range. So I ain't gonna lie, this was a pain in my butt. Just trying to situate those things up there, and I got them where I wanted to, and then one fell, and then they both fell off the platform. So I had to say a prayer real quick, bring myself back down, and then get back at it. So this is complete. Now I'm gonna try to start on the clearing out the shooting lane, and then hopefully while I'm in there in the woods, I can finish up that last little bit of trail, about, I think it's about 50 yards to finish up. But get that finished, wrapped up, and then put up my pop-up, and I should be pretty close to done with my chores I want out here, and then fiddle around. So keep watching. All right guys, so I got my shooting lane, I guess that's what I'm gonna call it, my shooting lane. I got it cleared out here in the woods coming to my stand. So tractor coming in off one of my main trails, and following it on up to, you see where I've been using the box blade. I use it to clear out all this stuff. It's probably taking me about an hour or so. If you look back in here, you'll see, I know all these videos, but this is what it all looked like. You know, it's all this saplings, little things, this nature. And vines. I wanted to get it all cleared out so I can see from my stand. Let's see if I can point it out. So if you can see, my stand is probably right there. You'll see some green vegetation. That's where that plot is that I was at. The little plot I put in to get your bearings straight, and then a shooting platform's right on that side. And my stand's in the middle, so I wanted a clear shot coming through this way. I've been able to in the past, been able to see heads moving and stuff, but there's so many branches that can deflect the bullet. Then also, if I decide to get a muzzleloader next year, get this all cleaned out. But I've got some extra seed. I know it's late in the season, but it ain't gonna hurt nothing. So I'm just gonna come and spread seed all out through here, the stuff that I got from Tractor Supply. So, tractor, it's earning its keep today. Got this cleared out. Got a nice, it's probably about a 75, 80 yard shot. But it's just been something that's been bugging me. Every time you're sitting in a stand, you've been up there for hours on end, you're looking like, man, I wish that was all cleared out. Now it's done. So on to my next project. I think I'm gonna try to finish up the trail and then put it the pop up. So keep watching. All right, guys. So got as far as I can with the trail. There's a tree falling down, so I don't have a chainsaw, but just trying to get my bearings, or y'all's bearings. Right there is gonna be, that's where my platform was last year. I'll put a pop up there. And where I'm standing right now is where I killed my big buck last year, but you'll see I put one of those mineral rocks down here, and they're just tearing up the roots now, getting down in there. But like I said, I was trying to finish up the trail. This is the back end of the property, and I was able to get through here pretty quickly. And I got down about 35, 40 yards through here, and then I've got this tree that's laid down. So that's the end of the trails for me anyways today. Should have brought my chainsaw, but I need to work on it anyways. So I've been out here messing with a chainsaw and getting pissed off. But tree, just need to cut it, and all I've got left, I gotta figure out making like either a little bridge over this, or put a culvert down and put some gravel on top of it. But I've got it here, and I've got another one about 15 yards over, same thing. And then that's where the end of my trail finished up on the other one. So I mean, I've got access all the way around it. Now for the kids to be able to just drive continuously around it, they can't do it right now, which is probably good. It's hunting season, so don't want to scare everything off. But let me go put that pop up. Put that pop up, blind up, and then I think I'm gonna go sit in the stand for a little bit. I brought my bow. I know I probably scared off everything out here, but you know, just sit and didn't watch. You never know. Already out here. I just like the peace and quiet. So, all right. Y'all stay tuned. All right, guys. So after fighting over getting my pop up, I don't know why it's giving me a fit today, but got it up. Basically, I've had this for a while. I got this off marketplace as well. Scaffolding. Bought a couple sets because I've seen some done this way, and I just built a deck for it. And yeah, this has been very successful. I'm taking it down to my grandparents, set it up there, and then it's easy to take down. If I want to move it around anywhere else on the property, I can. But this is its home for this season. Got it zip tied down, so it should hold pretty good. So pretty much got all my chores done out here that I wanted to, and try to get up in that stand. So until next time, y'all take it easy.